Cube time again. Waste a lot of time trying to get set up there, so let's have a look at this pack. We have a Cold Steel Heart, a Nakatal, a Wheel of Fortune, a Moldrifter. Really tempted to pick the Wheel of Fortune and just kind of go all in on a silly combo, but that's much more difficult in this version of the cube. So I think the pick is kind of Moldrifter or Cold Steel Heart. I'm gonna be really boring. Cold Steel Heart here. Okay, the first card that's leapt out at me is this one Power Stone. Big fan of the artifact mana start to a draft. Fallen Shaman. Baneslayer is pretty powerful. Martial Coup is good. Dark Ritual. I was very tempted to take Wheel of Fortune. Had we taken Wheel of Fortune, we would have probably taken Dark Ritual from this pack. As it is, we'll take this one Power Stone. Might have taken the Brain Freeze had we gone in that direction. As it stands now, Sylvan Library or Strip Mine probably. I haven't seen the rest of the pack. Flicker Wisp has actually impressed me a lot in this cube. Yeah, so Strip Mine or Sylvan Library. Strip Mine's quite tempting with a little bit of artifact mana so that we can really push the mana advantage. And it's colorless, so it keeps us really open. But Sylvan Library is very good. Question though is how good? So you can draw some cards. It's nice with some shuffle effects. Very close. I'm gonna go with Strip Mine. It's just very powerful having a land that has such an effect, and I like that it keeps us open. Okay, I'm laughing because the first card that spoke to me was a Smokestack, which could go well in this kind of mana denial deck. Edict's good, Hero's good, Blood Crypt, Preordain, Snapcaster. I don't. I mean, normally I think I would probably take Snapcaster here, but you know what? I'm going to. I mean, I think we can wheel Smokestack, but I don't know about picking it and then kind of ignoring it. So, and I don't know what kind of color we'd like to go in our Smokestack deck. Like, do we go Mana Denial? Do we go Sinkhole? Are we kind of mono black artifact big stuff deck? Do we go blue? So, I mean, all right, let's go Smokestack. I mean, it's not super duper powerful card, but we'll see where it goes. So, I mean, Pernicious Deed is very good. It's less good when it blows up all of our own stuff. We've got a Mind's Desire. Have we gone on that silly combo route? So I'm thinking Pernicious Deed, Regrowth, and Pellucid Delta. Yeah, Regrowthing Strip Mine is quite good fun. I'd like to take the Delta. Just keep our keep super duper flexible. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. So, kind of looking at Fertile Ground here to kind of keep the ramp and just ramp. So yeah, I think we're gonna go Fertile Ground. Red would be quite a good fit with this mentality. We could Primal Command, put one of their put a land on top of their library and then dig up some kind of card. But maybe we'll wheel it. Probably won't, but let's take the Fertile Ground for now. This is a pretty do nothing pack. Shrine is very good in red. Unsurprisingly, Tibalt probably shouldn't be in the cube. Cathedral of War, it would fit the theme, but we don't have any creatures to go with it. I'll take the Tragic Slip. I've got a Delta, might be able to cast to keep it. Woo! Mog War Marshal Smokestack, that's quite a nice combo, but I'm not passing an upheaval. Shouldn't come this late. Sand Blaster might be quite good in this kind of theme. They can discard some cards, Necrotrar. Void Slime, if we want to be green blue, which we might well want to be. Void Slime or Ruin Blaster. Upheaval's more of a sign than Smokestack, so I'm gonna just try to kind of back that one up. Wake Thrush is fine, but keep some mana flexibility going. It's too bad Tumble Magnet doesn't tap land. Goblin Trencher Smokestack's quite a good combo. We'll take the Ravenous Baboons. Though, see where that leads. There, I don't really feel like picking any of these cards, to be honest. Orcish Lumberjack has some potential. So we're kind of five color mess right now. Don't really know what we're doing having picked Strip Mine and Smokestack. It's very possible we should have kind of gone a lot more red. We'll take the regrowth. Not really feeling like going that combo route. And if we are blue green, then Snake, Void Slime, Upheaval. It's not going to be the end of the world. Probably going to have to hide these shoddy red cards and probably the Smokestack. Oh well. You try and live a dream. It's not over yet, but it could be. Very slow draft. And let's see what we get for pack two. Gilded Lotus would be nice. Unplayable, unplayable. Kozilek. Xanath doesn't find us anything yet. Finding Snake is a bit awkward. Unplayable. Okay, this pack's really bad. I mean, we could go with Tectonic Edge. I mean, Strip Mine, Tectonic Edge, Ravenous Baboons, Smokestack. That kind of keeps us on board with the Mana Denial. Wildfire would have been quite nice. Feels like we're more blue-green than these red cards or really the Tragic Slip. And don't really feel like taking Kozilek here. So we're going to take the Memory Lapse. Just keep things going. Well, there's an Ulamog to go there. Jokkalhorpes, that's kind of cool. Destroy tons of stuff. Doesn't kill Planeswalkers, so you can have Planeswalker Jokkalhorpes control. It does blow up our artifact mana. So I think we're going to pick Demonic Tutor. We can splash it off Fertile Ground, Cold Steel Heart, Delta at the moment. It's a bit too bad that the Rampant Growth were passing here, but I like me a Demonic Tutor. So we have Primeval Titan, which we will probably pick. Probably, it seems to kind of fit wherever it is that we're headed. Thragtusk would be nice, Ponder would be nice, and a Volcanic Isle would be nice. But I think Primeval Titan just allows us. There's a Green Sun's Zenith that might wheel, and between all those cards, that kind of gives us a plan. Obliterate for another kind of effect along those lines. Upheaval, Obliterate, Jokkalhorpes. We could have the slowest, weirdest deck in the world. Hellkite might play. Misty Rainforest would be really good. We're going to pick this Kadama's Reach though, just to keep ramping, keep mana fixing. thought they might have gone back in time and added a guild sign to just to any gold card that it kind of fits. But nice to see that they haven't. I apologize about how slow this draft is going. I mean, there's not much I can do about it, but fine. Okay, Plowunder jumps out to me. Braids is a little bit out of the blue. Water of Grave would be nice, but let's take the Plowunder and keep that kind of acceleration mana and all. It'd be quite nice to get a Jiraga Tree Speaker, something like that. It is unlikely that we'll play these two red cards. Although having said that, if that it looks like with Raging Ravine, Fertile Ground, Coldsteel Heart, and Kadama's Reach, Ravenous Baboons might well be a free splash, which we kind of might want. It's a pity that the Primal Command didn't wheel. I can't remember what we picked over it. Felt like it was significantly better at the time. I really can't remember what we did pick over it. Yawgmoth, I mean, Tangle Wire, does this fit our theme? I think it does. So we could play Badlands. So Badlands or Tangle Wire, I'm trying to figure out which is the pick here. Badlands would mean that our Delta gives us access to red, really increasing the freedom of that splash. Yeah, let's take the Tangle Wire. I think it's a little too risky. It would probably wheel, but it could be a little bit too risky. I'm getting Tigon Predator here. I was looking at Smash to Smithereens, but it's been quite nice. I'd be cool wheeling Smash or Woodfall Primus with Thundering Titan. That'd be quite cool. But for now, I mean, this could just blow up opposing Earthbound mana, and it's generally quite a efficient creature. And I played it in the only Vintage tournament I've ever played in, so it can't be too bad. Huh, Nicol Bolas would be a bit of a stretch. Pyroclasm would be fine, Jett would be fine. Thirst for Knowledge, probably the pick. Although I'm going to stare at Nicol. I mean, Mastical is fine too. Can we get this in the deck? So Primeval Titan, yeah. I can't really pass Nicol Bolas. Okay, guys, we're doing it. Four color non-white. So going to cut a Lumberjack. Nicol Bolas, that blows up non-creature permanents, doesn't it? Use it to keep the LD plan going. 8 mana Stone Rune. So there's not much card draw. I mean, I know we just passed a Thirst for Knowledge, but we have a bit of acceleration and a few cards that put our opponent back with Plowunder and Tangle Wire, but we don't really kind of eke out an advantage unless we rip Nicol Bolas or a Primeval Titan. Or put us in the position to reset the game with an upheaval but leave ourselves ahead. The only cards that we might play are Tandem Lookout and Kozilek. Don't really have enough guys to be considering Lookout, so we'll take the Kozilek. Probably not going to play it, but we could get a we could just get a bunch of random cards that could get there. I think that means that Zenith didn't wheel. I mean, it wouldn't mean phenomenal in our deck. Trigon Predator is the only other real card that we can get with it. But having double Titan would have given us a plan. Brine Elemental. 7 mana unmorph. They don't get an untapped step. That's kind of on theme. But I think turning all of our men into Ophidians might be a little bit better. Not that we have many men with which to do it. Just gonna. I've used Phantasmal Bear to effect in the sideboard. We're not going to play these, and Obliterate could be cool. not really going to play this clifftop retreat. I mean, we don't really want either color, but we could. We, you know, that's the answer. And we likewise with braids. yeah, historical. Why not? Braid smokestack, eh?